point to the one that looks good, I think that, that's mission accomplished. Anyway, so the point here is the optics problem that I think we solved, and that is to have two comparable beams in power interfere rather than one negative. I want to disclose that I started this company, FiOptics, that is commercializing this with other graduate students. So there's no graduate student needed. They took whatever we had on the table and they made it into a nice box. Okay, so with this, thank you very much for your attention.
Doing phase imaging of the tissue slides,
yeah.
And the thickness of the tissue will affect the phase delay. And what's the typical roughness of the tissue slides?
Good question. So if, so I don't have a clear cut answer, what's the roughness of the tissue? We don't know. But we did some ACM images, and what we found is that the profile kind of fluctuation are low frequency, are much smoother than the scale that we're looking at, let's say cell scale, like 10 microns. It would be a very bad cutting or a very bad staff person that, where the cutting will have errors at the micron scale, okay? So while you may have global profile errors due to cutting, it's true, that may happen. They are, from what we measured with SCM, they are at a much bigger scale than what we are analyzing. We are looking also into parameters that are thickness independent. Okay, so you can imagine you can do a normalization of, it's not going to be G anymore, it's not going to be an isotopy factor, it might be normalized Laplacian of some sort. So we could take thickness out of the picture altogether. But so far it didn't seem to be an issue. So all this, we didn't correct for any thickness changes, everything, all these results are assuming no thickness error. So we correct for that, we might get even better.
So with the mass that you showed in the NGI gym, here I am. So is there now a limitation on thickness, or is it completely gone?
There's always a limitation. So now Roger Cam is sending me embryoid bodies that are a millimeter thick. So as excited as I was to look at them now, a millimeter. We're collaborating with my wife also. She gave us a millimeter thick cube of brain, fixed, cleared, and looks like a mess.
So basically my question is, so how thick could you go with the SLIM, and how much can you go with the image?
So it's hard to put hard numbers. It's not the thickness that's important, right? So in the eye, we go through 1 inch. Okay, so it's not the thickness, it's the scattering length. So I would say this SLIM does not work over one scattering length. Once the multiple scattering sets in, SLIM starts to fail. Okay? This gym, the new thing, is works after that. Okay? So that would be the main difference. Now, how to put a clear thickness number, I need to know the scattering. Okay, so if you give me a more transparent stuff, I could go through thicker. But it seems like I cannot go, even with this new one, I cannot go through a whole brain of a mouse, which would be really nice. It's, you have to think of something else, I don't know.
I think Randy plans to take this home, but this is for our speakers.
Thank you very much.